Hey, what's up guys, KSK here. Welcome back to another video. Now, in this video, I will show you how to dual boot Arch Linux with Windows 11 or Windows 10. Now, this guide is one of the safest ways to set up a dual boot on any computer without any data loss. Also, at the end of this video, I will show you how to remove Arch Linux safely from the dual boot. So make sure to watch the video until the end to avoid any confusion. Now keep in mind, I assume that your PC is running Windows 11 or Windows 10 in UEFI mode with a GPT formatted drive. So legacy BIOS users, I will be posting a dedicated video in the upcoming weeks. So stay tuned to my channel. So if you haven't yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button right now and tap on the bell icon to receive the post notifications. Now, unlike other Linux distros, installing Arch Linux is not that easy. You need to be very careful of what you are doing. A small mistake can lead to the data loss. But don't worry, I'll walk you through the whole video and explain everything step by step. So watch this video till to the end and do not miss any parts of the video. I repeat, do not skip any parts of the video. Also, check the description down below for useful information, timestamps, and download links. Now, as per my testing, if you follow this video carefully, you will be able to successfully dual boot your Windows 11 or Windows 10 PC with Arch Linux. The prerequisites of this video, you need a Windows 11 or Windows 10 running on your PC or laptop. Next, you need an 8 gigs or higher pen drive to create a bootable disk with Arch Linux. Now, lastly, you need to reserve the free space of 30 GB or higher from your drive. All right, so as you can see, this is my PC running the latest version of Windows 11. Now, like I said, it also works for Windows 10. Now, that being said, moving into a first step. Now, on your Windows computer, open your favorite browser and head over to the official website of Arch Linux. Now, on the top right, you can see the big download button. Go ahead, tap on it. Now, it will take you over here. To download Arch Linux ISO, you need a BitTorrent client. Now, I'll leave a link to the torrent application. Just install an .exe file and you are good to go. Now, once the BitTorrent client has been installed on your computer, you can run the magnetic link or download the torrent file. Now, I'm going to choose the second option. Now, once it's downloaded, open it. Now, this will launch the BitTorrent client. Now, just go ahead and download Arch Linux. Then head over to the second link and download the latest version of Rufus. You can also use a Balina etcher, but I choose to prefer Rufus for the sake of this video. Now, once it's done downloading the files, place them somewhere on your computer for easier navigation. To install Arch Linux on your computer, you first need to burn an ISO to the pen drive to make a bootable USB. Go ahead, connect your pen drive to the computer via USB port. Now open Rufus tool with admin rights. Here, select your drive from here and import Arch ISO. Now, since my PC is running in UEFI mode, I'm going to use the GPT partition scheme. Then tap on the start button to make the bootable USB with Arch Linux. Since we are installing Arch Linux alongside with Windows 11 on the same drive, you need to allocate a free space. To do so, open the command prompt. Then inside here, type this command. Now you can see the Windows Disk Manager. The Disk Manager is a special tool in Windows OS that helps to manipulate the drives. Now this will list all of the connected drives. Now as you can see, in my case, only two drives are visible. The drive 0 is my main SSD where Windows 11 has been installed, and the drive 1 is my USB drive. Now, as you can see, drive 0 is using a GPT partition scheme. Now, if you notice inside drive 0, you can see all of the partitions. The first partition is known as EFI or ESP, which is where the Windows bootloader is present. Now, we will be using the same ESP partition to install a grub bootloader for Arch Linux. Now, next to the EFI partition, you can see a C partition where Windows 11 files are located, and the last one is the recovery. Now, use the C drive or any other to shrink the free space for Arch Linux. To do this, right-click on the desired partition and choose Shrink Volume. Now, in my case, I have a plenty of space left on my drive. Now, I'm going to allocate a 70 GB for Arch installation, but just type in megabytes. Now, once it's done, tap on Shrink. Now, this will create a brand new partition, which is called unallocated. Now, using this free space, we're going to install Arch Linux in a moment. Now, once it's done, exit the disk manager and reboot your computer. Now, while it's rebooting, head over to the BIOS menu by pressing the valid keys on your keyboard. Now, in my case, F2 is the key to boot into BIOS. Now, inside BIOS, look for the Intel Rapid Storage technology and disable it. Also, make sure to disable the secure boot during the Arch Linux installation. This is very important. So if you don't disable secure boot, Arch Linux may not gonna work properly. Now, once you finish installing Arch Linux, you can re-enable the secure boot if you need it so. Now, save the changes and reboot the system. While it's rebooting, this time hold F2 or F12 or F10 to go to the boot menu. Now, here you can see your pen drive. If you don't see your thumb drive over here, so make sure you have enabled the USB boot inside the BIOS settings. Now, choose your pen drive to boot into the live session of Arch Linux. Now, on your monitor, you can see a terminal that is expecting to type something. So you might be thinking, where is the GUI installer? Well, this is called Arch Linux. Now, everything can be done with a command. Now, you need to type a bunch of commands to make the Arch system functional. Now, don't worry, from this part onwards, you may end up typing a lot of commands. Now, I suggest you taking a notes and write all these commands somewhere. Now, this could be extremely useful and may help you to reinstall the Arch Linux in the future by using the same commands. Now, anyway, on your monitor screen, so you may see this prompt which is expecting some input. Now, keep in mind the mouse functionality is disabled. You have to rely on the keyboard. All right, so the first command we're going to type is going to increase the size of the console. So just going to go type set font. TER-132N. Now, make sure you type exactly what you see over here. It is a case sensitive. Then press the Enter key to execute this command. Now, you can see the size of the console has incremented and looks much better. To demonstrate this video, I have remotely logged into Arch Linux via SSH. Now, before installing Arch Linux, so make sure your PC has connected to the internet. To check whether the internet connection is working, type this command. Now, if you see replies from the server, then you are good to go. To see the network interfaces on your computer, type IP-C and small a. Now, this will list all of the network interfaces. Now, in my case, my PC is connected to the internet via Ethernet port. Now, if in case your system has a Wi-Fi adapter, you can check the description down below to see how to connect to Wi-Fi and access the internet. Next, we're going to verify the EFI boot by typing this command. Now, if you see all the text like this, congratulations, your system is booted in UEFI mode. Now, let me go ahead and clear the console screen to make it look better. Next, we're gonna need to update the time and date. Just type time date CTL status, and you can see the current time and the universal time. Now, if you notice, the time zone is set to UTC. Now, in my case, I live in India, so I'm gonna update the time based on my location. To do so, time date CTL. list-time zones. Now this shows all of the continents along with the city names. Now I'm going to look for Asia and Kolkata. Then I'm going to press the Enter key to see the list of cities and the name of the continent. Now once you have done looking through and found the country name or the city name, then type letter Q on the keyboard to exit. Now type time date CTL set-time zone Asia and Kolkata. Now this will update the time and date according to my city. Next up, you need to set up a keyboard layout for the console. Now, by default, the keyboard layout is set to English, United States. Now, if your keyboard layout is German or the United Kingdom, you can change it accordingly. To list out the available keyboard layouts, type ls/user/share/kbd/keymaps, then press the tab key to see the suggestions. In my case, I'm going to use i386 QWERTY. And again, press the tab key to see the suggestions. Now here you can see a bunch of QWERTY keyboards. Now I'm going to use us.map.gz. Now even though the default console layout is set to US, I'm just showing you guys how to find and set the keyboard layout you want. Now anyway, once you find your desired keyboard layout, type load keys and the name of the keyboard layout. Now type lsblk to list out all of the drives connected to the PC. Now in this case, you can see the two main drives. Now forget about the loops, just concentrate on the SDA or NVMe. The SDA is the main drive where Windows 11 has been installed, and the SDB is my USB, which is from the current live session of Arch Linux is running. Now if in case you have connected more than two drives and are not sure which drive is the proper one to install Arch Linux, you can draw an hdparm-i/dev and the name of the drive, in this case SDA. Now this shows the vendor name of the drive and more information. Now that way you can verify the drive. You can also use fdisk-l to see more information about your drives. Now as you can see, SDA is the drive where Windows 11 has been installed. Now it's time to create a partitions for Arch Linux using the free space which we have created in step number 3. Now type cfdisk/dev/sda to see all the partitions. Now here you can see the EFI partition and Windows partitions. Now keep in mind, you need to use arrow keys for selection and the Enter key for confirmation. Now scroll to the free space. For Arch Linux, we need to create a 3 main partitions: root, home, and swap. Now EFI or ESP partition is already present on the GPT formatted drive. Now we can use a devsda1, the EFI partition, to install the grub bootloader later. Now for now, select the free space, then I'm going to create a root partition with 30 GB and press the Enter key to create it. The type is going to be a Linux file system, and the cfdisk will pick automatically. Now again, select the free space. Then I'm going to allocate 30 GB for the home partition, which is where all the personal files are stored. Now lastly, use the remaining free space for swap, which can be used as a virtual RAM. And the type for this partition is swap. That's it. Now we have done creating the partitions for Arch Linux. Now write the changes to alter the disk. Now once it's done, exit from the cfdisk. Now if you type lsblk, you can see all the newly created partitions: the SDA5 for root, SDA6 for home, and SDA7 for swap. Now we need to format these partitions one by one. Now first, we're gonna format the root partition, so which in my case is SDA5, by typing mkfs.xt4 /dev/SDA5. Then format the home partition with the same command. I'm gonna replace SDA5 with SDA6. Now, lastly, I'm gonna format the SDA7 by typing mkswap /dev/SDA7. Now enable the swap partition by typing swap on /dev/SDA7. Now you can see the swap mounting point. The same way you need to mount the root and home partitions to the live USB. Now first, I'm gonna mount the root partition, so which in my case is SDA5 to the MNT. Then create a directory inside the MNT and name it as home. Now go ahead and mount the home partition to this directory. Now make sure all the partitions are mounted properly. You can verify it by typing lsblk. Now for now, we are not gonna mount the EFI partition. Now it's time to install Arch Linux, but before that, type this command to back up the current mirror list. Now what we are doing right now is that we are backing up the mirror list, which contains the URL of the Arch Linux servers. There are a lot of Arch servers that are running, but all of them are not super fast. We're gonna filter the top 10 best servers of Arch Linux and use them to speed up the Arch installation. Now update the pacman databases by typing pacman -S and small y. Then type this command to install the rank mirrors tool. Now next up, type this command to filter the top 10 fastest servers of Arch Linux. Now if you notice, rank mirrors will look into the backup file, filter the top 10 fastest servers, and update the actual mirror list. Now this should take some time and do not interrupt the process. All right, so once it's done, if you read the mirror list, and these are the top 10 best Arch servers that are active at the moment. Now if in case you see any slower download speeds, you can use this command. Now it's time to install the Arch Linux to the root partition, which is mounted to MNT. To do so, type pacstrap -i/MNT base for the base Arch system, base -deval, Linux for the kernel. Now if you want LTS kernel, you can type linux-lts. In my case, I'm gonna install the both kernels. Then I need linux-headers, Linux firmware, Intel Ucode for Intel processors. For AMD users, type AMD-Ucode. Then I'm going to install a bunch of packages like sudo, nano, git, vim, neofetch, network manager, DHCP, CD. Now if you have a WLAN interfaces, you can use WPA supplicant. And for Bluetooth support, you can add a Blues module. Now for now, I don't need all these. And lastly, I'm gonna type pulse audio. That's it. Now once it's done, run this command to start installing the base system of Arch Linux. Now as you can see, the total download size is 760 megabytes. Now this will take some time. Sit back and relax and don't interrupt the computer. And that's it. Now we have done the base installation of Arch Linux. Now it's time to generate a file system table, also known as fstab. Now if you notice, the SDA partitions are mounted to the live session of USB. But when we boot the Arch from the main drive, we need to tell the system to mount all these partitions to the same location. Now for that, type this command to generate the fstab file. Now here you can see all of the partitions and their mounting points are written correctly. So far we are running everything from the live session of Arch Linux. It's time to enter into the drive where we have installed Arch Linux. Now for that, type arch-chroot/mnt. Now you can see the prompt has changed to something else, which means we have entered into the actual drive as a root user. Now you can verify that by typing lsblk to see all the partitions and their mounting points. Now first type passwd and set the root password. Now this is a super user account and is known as a top tier user in Linux. Now you should never run the system as a root user, it's not a good practice. Now for that, we're going to create a standard user by typing user add-m and the name of the user. Then set the password by typing passwd and the name of the user. Now once it's done, type this command usermod-a and capital G. And I'm going to add the new user to the VL group to execute anything with root privileges. I'm going to also add to a storage and power groups. Now make sure you type exactly as it is, and there should not be any space between the groups after the comma. Now we have added this new user to the VL group, which allows the user to access root privileges with a sudo command. Now for that, we need to edit the sudoers file. Now by default, you can type a vsudo to edit the sudoers file with a vim, but I'm going to edit with a nano text editor by typing this command. Now inside the nano text editor, scroll all the way and uncomment this line. You can also add this line, which is responsible for reprompting the user for the password after a specific amount of time. Now once it's done, press Ctrl+O to write the changes and press Ctrl+X to exit from the text editor. Now it's time to set a system language by generating a locale. Now type this command, then scroll all the way and uncomment this line. Now this is going to tell the system to use an American English as the system locale. Now type this command and generate a locale. Now create a local config file by typing this command. Then export the system language by typing this command. Now type this command to set up the host name of this computer. So in my case, I'm going to say Arch Linux KDE. Then type nano/etc hosts and add these lines. Now make sure you replace this part with your host name and save the changes. It's time to set the time zone or region and link this information with the local time. Now for that, type ln-sf/user share, then zone information, and press the tab key to see the list. In my case, I belong to Asia and Kolkata. Now type hwclock-sys to hc to sync the current time. And it's time to install the grub bootloader, which is going to help boot Arch Linux. To do so, first type lsblk, and the SDA1 is the EFI partition, where we're going to install a grub bootloader. Now create a directory called EFI inside the boot. Then mount the EFI partition to this directory by typing mount /dev sda1, then /boot and EFI. Now type pacman-S grub EFI boot manager .fstools/mtools to install all these packages. Once it's done, now edit the grub file with this command, then scroll to the bottom and uncomment this line. Now, if you don't set the OS prober value to false, then grub cannot look for the Windows bootloader and won't add it to the grub menu. Now, once it's done, save the changes by pressing Ctrl+O and exit with Ctrl+X. Now, install OS prober via pacman. Then install a grub with some arguments. Now type the command exactly as you see over here. Now right now the target parameter specifies the system architecture, so which is x86 or 64. Once it's done, now generate a grub config file by typing grub-mkconfig-o/boot/grub and /grub.cfg to update the grub config file. And that's it. Now you can see the grub has detected the Windows bootloader and added to the boot menu. Now lastly, enable the network services. Now first we're going to enable a DHCP using a systemctl command. Now this is responsible for providing the IP address. Then enable the network manager service, which lets you use the internet connection. Now type the command exactly what you see. Once it's done, now exit from the ch root environment. Now type umount-lR and /mnt to unmount all of the partitions. Now once it's done, reboot the system and eject the pen drive. That's it. Now we have successfully installed Arch Linux and dual booted with Windows 11 or Windows 10. Now once the system is restarted, you can see the grub menu. Now from here you can boot into Arch. You can boot into Arch or Windows 11. Now for now, let's just boot into Arch Linux. Now log in with your user account. Then update the pacman databases by typing sudo pacman-SY. Now it's time to install the desktop environment. I'm going to install a Plasma desktop by KDE. To do so, type sudo pacman-S. I'm going to install an xarg meta package, then xarg-xinit, then xterm for xterminal, plasma, plasma-desktop. Now, if you prefer to use a Valent session, you can use it, but I don't recommend using the Valent on the old computers. Then I'm going to install all KDE applications, KDE Plasma add-ons, and SDDM, which is a simple display manager. Now this is going to install the desktop environment and other packages on the top of the Arch Linux base system. Now wait for some time. Once the installation process has been completed, I will be right back with you. Now type this command and create an xinitrc file inside the home directory. Then add this line and save the changes. Now enable the display manager using a systemctl command. And that's it. Now reboot the computer. And this time, Arch Linux will boot with the Plasma desktop. Now for some reason, Wayland is not working fine with my system. I'm going to switch to Plasma X11. That's it. Now we have successfully installed the Plasma desktop. Now, as a bonus part of this video, so if in case you don't like Arch Linux and decide to uninstall, then reboot your computer to Windows 11. Now, inside Windows 11, open Disk Manager by typing this command on the search bar or inside the command prompt. Now, here you can see next to the C drive, the three partitions which we have created for Arch Linux. Just go ahead and delete these three partitions carefully, one after the other. Now once it's deleted, you can see an unallocated free space. You can use this free space in a Windows OS by using an extended volume option. Now lastly, we need to do one more important step to remove the grub bootloader from the EFI partition. And for that, we need to take a command prompt help. Go ahead, open the command prompt with admin privileges. Now inside here, type a disk part, then type list disk. Now as you can see, this is my main drive. Now we need to select this drive by typing this command. Then type a list partition. and it's going to show all of the partitions present inside this drive. Now we need to look for a partition named as system, also known as EFI partition. Now in my case, it's the first one. Now select this partition by typing this command. Then assign a drive letter to mount this partition. Now once the drive letter is assigned to the EFI partition, exit from the disk part. Now type this drive letter with a colon assigned for the EFI partition, which in my case is letter X, and press the return key. Now type cd EFI to change the directory into the EFI partition. Then again type dir to see the contents on this folder. And here you can see both Windows and Linux bootable files are present. Right now it's showing as grub UEFI. Anyway, just gonna go ahead and remove this folder by typing this command. Now this indeed is going to remove all of the grub files related to Arch Linux. Now that way you won't end up facing any grub issues. Now once it's done, now you have successfully removed Arch Linux from the dualBoot. Now restart the computer and you can see the system should boot into Windows 11 or Windows 10 without any issues. And that's pretty much it. This is how you do boot Arch Linux and Windows 11 on the same drive. Now if in case you like this video, hit the thumbs up button down there and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and consider hitting the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a new video. Also, if in case you have any suggestions, post them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching my video. This has been KSK Ryle. I'll catch you in my next video. Peace.